the link between HIV and cancer has actually been present right from the beginning. So in fact, if you go back, one of the very first indications that HIV had entered the human population was that a cancer called kaposi-sarcoma started to occur in young men in New York and San Francisco who would never otherwise have had that tumour. So for 30 years we've been aware of this link. Over time though, we've had tremendous success in improving therapies for people with HIV. We're now seeing people with HIV aging into the period of greatest cancer risk, and we're going to need to be able to respond to that. While people with HIV are at a greatly elevated risk of cancer, they're disproportionately affected by cancer, they're almost always excluded from clinical trials for cancer-related drugs because of the complexity of their condition. I became interested in working on HIV-related cancers for a couple of reasons. First of all, because I think there's a really important clinical need for people with HIV. With the successes we've had in HIV treatments, there's still a really substantial need for that sort of work. The other thing that I think is fascinating about HIV-related cancers is they provide a window through which we can learn a whole lot about cancer in other settings. This program of work brings together the tremendous advances that we've seen in immune modulatory anti-cancer drugs and applies it to a series of different opportunities to improve outcomes for people with HIV-related cancers. It's possible that these immune modulatory anti-cancer drugs are also going to disturb the cells where HIV is hiding out of reach of antiretroviral therapy. If that's the case, it would open up an avenue potentially to eradicating or even curing HIV with these drugs or drugs like them. And that's an area that we'll be looking at within these clinical trials. The Cancer Institute of New South Wales support is absolutely crucial to this program of research in HIV-associated malignancies. And I think it shows the vision of the Cancer Institute's program that they've been willing to support work in an area that's new to New South Wales and that brings together HIV and cancer researchers in a way that's new to us and I think very exciting. I think the work we're doing here in New South Wales is providing a model that will lead the way elsewhere. One of the things I find tremendously satisfying about being a clinician scientist is being able to see both the elegance of the laboratory research and its impact on people in the same week, really. I would be very hopeful that the treatments we're developing will be improving outcomes for patients in the very near future.